and the girl who loves the sea. It calls me.
Ngiyabingelela yeah, abantu abedlozi. This is part 2 of Water Child lesson. Ku part 1 la sasikade sikhuluma khona ukuthi kunabanye benu from the beginning of June abe kunezinto ezithize kade be experience in their lives, some changes that they were experiencing, and I named a few on that video. So namhlanje I am going to talk about part 2 walokho esasikhulume the day. Okay, ezinye ke zezinto that you are experiencing umntwana bamanzi ukubhodla nokuzamula frequently as from qala nje uJune. Ubhodla kakhulu, uzamula kakhulu, nje ngeindlela eziningi, the burping and the yawning, it's just too much. Maybe it was something that was an on and off thing, but currently, recently, as you're experiencing all those signs that I've mentioned in part 1, where I was talking about feeling tired all the time, waking up and being confused, vivid dreams, forgetting dreams, traveling through your sleep, the visions of seeing abantu abadala, whether in your sleep or were you dreaming, you know, all those frequent water dreams that you were having that I discussed on part one. And then in addition to that, ubhodla kakhulu, uzamula kakhulu this time, and you can't even control yourself. It's one of the things you'll be experiencing as well. And also any into you've noticed your diet, that you don't feel like eating anymore. I know mostly uzoba nenkinga yokudla mas, ube nenkinga hlambda yokudla amaqanda. What other foods can I think of? I know that most of us are having an issue. Abanye, they even have an issue when it comes to mutton, specifically mutton. Angangaba nenkinga ne beef, but mutton. Abanye, they having that feeling that they just don't like chicken recently. After all this has started happening, uzizo awusayithandi inkukhu, awusawathandi amasi, you don't have that sudden interest for amaqanda, and inokunye nje. Uma buzothi udla lezo zinto by forcing yourself, you start getting sick, you have stomach cramps, you might have diarrhea, you know, just those food make you sick, they even taste funny. So those are some of the things you're currently experiencing. And also your skin. Yes, it's winter, but now it's getting worse in terms of dry skin. Kuyabuya ne rash that you maybe had a long time ago, and now you're starting to get rashy. Your skin is quite dry. It's itchy, and you notice that maybe a product, maybe a body lotion or a body wash or noma ngabe yini lo that you use normally to bath yourself, usuyaqala uyizwa ngathi yakuncinza. There's the feeling when you're using something like you're suddenly allergic to that thing. But yet you know very well, I've been using this product for a very long time. But however, why is it now when I'm using this, when I'm using this lotion, when I'm using this soap, when I'm using this shower gel or noma ngabe yini le, but you're suddenly feeling like you're allergic to it. It might give you an itchy skin condition, it might give you rashes and everything, but kunaleyo change le ekhona ukuthi there are specific things now that are happening on your skin, even if it's products that you were using currently or you were using before, but now it's just giving you that allergic reaction in your body. These are some of the things you experience also. And also enyini, though, you're extremely moody, you're annoyed, you are lazy most of the time, hence it goes with you being sleepy and tired all the time. So in this case also, you are quite very, very moody. We are funa ukuhlala wedwa all the time, you don't want anyone next to you, even if it's your own kids, you feel like I just want to be alone. Those are some of the things that you are experiencing also this time. Don't think ukuthi I konide wrong ngami, why suddenly I'm moody, why I'm not in the mood for people anymore, why I'm so annoyed, why do I feel lazy. Sometimes you don't even feel like getting up to go to work. Sometimes you don't even feel like doing absolutely nothing in the house. Those are some of the things that you're facing currently. So zonke lezo zinto, it all goes to what I said on part one, ukuthi idlozi lakho, imimoya yakho, abantu bamanzi bakho, they are active. And it might be ukuthi you need to go to the waters for cleansing. It might be ukuthi bafuna amagobongo abo, but bayazikhulumela bona currently ukuthi yini le ebaphakamisile, yini le edingekalayo kuwena yokuthi ukwazi ukuthi lesi sikhathi lesi sabo la basaphakeme khona yini efanele wena uyenze. So it's very important that you really, really, really need to stick to that diet. If you feel good, I don't want chicken. I don't know. Suddenly, I just don't want chicken. It makes me sick. I don't want a masi. I don't want mutton or whatever food that it might be that you feel good. I don't like this anymore. Then stop for that time. Ukuthi ukudle lokho kudle lokho kudla lokho until you see ukuthi kwenzakalani ekuhambeni kwesikhathi. Listen to your dreams. Balalele ukuthi bakhuluma bathini kuwena through those dreams, because they are revealing a lot. And mostly this time, it's where they are revealing your enemies. It's where they are revealing abantu abeze kahle also in your life. Because remember, it's not always ukuthi abantu abadala, when they talk to us through our dreams, they always showing us abathakathi, always showing us abantu abangenzi kahle, always showing us abantu abasifisela ukubi or okanye abantu abasikhuluma kabi. They also talking through our dreams, talking through our visions, also showing us abantu who are bringing good in our lives, also showing us abantu who are good benefits to be in our lives. Yabon? And they're also showing you who is it that needs your help currently in their lives. There might be people who are in desperate need of your help. However, abanye abantu, they are scared to approach you. Or omunye angazi ukuthi uzokuapproach uthini. So all this time, all this, I can say it's an awakening. Le process yabo le abaphakeme ngayo, there's a lot that they reveal to you. They reveal to you even things ezenzeka emagcekeni akho. They're revealing things that are happening at your workplace. They are revealing things that are happening within your families. You just pay close attention to whatever that they are telling you through that. But most of the time, listen to ente basuke beyikhuluma nawe, and you do about that le abasuke beyikhuluma. If there's a certain message that they are passing and they want you to take action, then you go and take action. If they want you in the waters, as I said previously, you have to go to the waters. Let alone ukuthi it's winter, it's cold, and yonke lezo zinto, this is the time ke manje you listen to your spirits and you do it. Because ama water spirits, good people, they are very aggressive if they are ignored. Because mostly njengamanje, but they are awake. They are taking their place in your life. So use that opportunity. If you feel ukuthi, hey, yazi, I feel like maybe they are showing me or leading me to someone to go and consult, or they are showing me and leading me to someone to go and seek for help or seek for noma ngabe yiphi leyo situation, then you listen to that. Who are they leading you to? Then you go and do that. This is the opportunity for you to use this time. Bonge laba kade bethi imimoya yami gogo ayiphakeme, but now they are feeling all of this. Iphakeme ke imoya yakho. Use this opportunity. And also, stop going to a place or a gobela that you have been using for some time but you're not seeing progress in your life. That's an indication ukuthi lo muntu is not for you. That's an indication to show you ukuthi lo gobela akanayo authority or power to assist you ngemimoya yakho. So musa ukuloke frequently. You seeing ukuthi uyahamba lo gobela, you go for a certain problem athi uzokusiza kube khona lokho, but again and again and again and again, hayi gogo okanye mkhulu, I'm not seeing a change. Instead, I'm seeing things getting worse. So what is it athi mhlambe asambe siye emanzini, asambe siye entabeni, asambe siyokwenza lokhu, asambe siyokwenza mntwana wedlozi? That is a red flag for you to show you ukuthi cha, lo muntu lo is not for me. Angeke umuntu umlethelwe idlozi lakho, umlethelwe imimoya yakho uthi une problem, and then a problem every time you do this, it doesn't stop. You do that, it doesn't stop. You do this, nize nenze izinto eziningi at once. you know, but still you're not seeing a change in your life. Instead, things are just getting worse. Then that's a red flag. Ukuthi move away from that person. Muyeke lo wogobela, phahlela abantu abadala, ubabuze ukuthi kanti sekufanele ngiye kuphi abantu abadala. It can be ukuthi when uyele kulo wogobela ngoba ucabanga ukuthi uyena ozokusiza, mhlawumbe akubona bakulidile ukuthi uhambe uye lapho. So just listen to imimoya yakho. Yabo njengamanje njengoba be active, use this time to do right, so that isn't those are going to hamba right. But lokobela lo loku hamba kuyena frequently in all of the time, you're not seeing change because abaningi, that's what they're experiencing. But gogo nginokobela I've been using for some time, but every time bengithi ngiyalungisa izinto athi hayi it's gonna get better, we change i-style sokwenza, we change izinto eyiningi zokwenza, we change izimpande, but still I'm not getting help. You know ukuthi lapho okay, akuyona indawo engichuzelwe yona yokuthi ngizolashwa imimoya yami. Akuyona indawo engichuzele yona okanye umuntu engichuzele yena ukuthi azongilapha empilweni yami. So don't get stuck with someone or people that you see that you're not seeing progress in your life, because umuntu belethwe idlozi. You see progress in your life. You see progress even after usukhulumile nomuntu engakakuthinti ngisho ngezandla zakhe, ningakakhulumi ngisho ukwenza izinto eziningi, but suddenly you just seeing progress in your life. Then you know ukuthi lo muntu loyo idlozi sukele kutshengisa into ethize ngaye, especially ibuzo ukuthi ukade ukhulumile naye okanye noma umbonile ningakaqali any progress or anything with that person, and then suddenly usubona kunama changes that are happening ekade nga owafune lawo ma changes engenze engakenzi lutho ngawe. Then abantu abadala basuke bekutshengisa ukuthi this is the person that you need to stick to. So baningi abantwana bedlozi Nkosi yami abastakhe eyindaweni engafanele ngaba bastakhe kuzona, abahleli eyintwasweni ekufanele ngaba bahleli kuzona. Understand one thing, uma busephehlweni instead of you ukuthi izinto zakho zibe nokuvuleka, you seeing that I'm drowning, instead of me getting better I'm drowning, instead of me getting better I'm more sicker than I was before, every time ngiyadla amagobongo, every time ngiyadla everything engiyidla impande yakulesi sigodlo, but I'm not getting better, then that's a red flag for you to move out and go home and uqale phansi abantu abadala ulalele ukuthi bathini. Awukwazi ukuthi usephehlweni and yet expecte ukuthi izinto zakho zihambe kahle zingahambe kahle. Khumbula ukuthi uma busephehlweni usephehlweni uzothwasela leli dloze kuyilona elidinga ukuthi ulithwasele. I've explained in one of the videos ukuthi usukuyelana entwasweni. It can be ukuthi lowo moya nawo awuzange uzuqede, it can be ukuthi waqeda ukusebenzisa ngenye indlela ethize naye, kuningi indlela eyisuke zisiyesele ukuthi siye emaphehlweni. But uma usufikile kulelo phehlo, especially lelo hambele wena waya kulona, maybe you referred by someone ukuthi hayi kunogobela mina engimaziyo, maybe uzokusiza, wathi qala nje ukukonsultela wathi hayi wena fanele uthwase, and usuyathwasa nawe same time. It can be someone you've known a long time, it can be a family gobela and everything. It does not mean ukuthi lo muntu just because we family gobela it means that person is meant for you. Lalelo wakhe imimoya ukuthi njani. Ziningi izindlela ezigcina sizisilida ukuthi singene ezigodlweni ezirong ngoba sithi sifuna usizo. So usephehlweni, you're not seeing change in your life. Instead you are drowning, instead you're having bad dreams, you're having amaphupho atshengisa ukucasuka kwedlozi, izinto eziningi ziyenzeka. Ugobela wakho ulocate hayi sozama ngale ndlela. It's a sign to say go home. Relook what you are doing and see what is it that I've went wrong, because the main problem in that scenario it's the place where you are, la ekuyona kufanele ngaba ukho khona in the first place. If usephehlweni eli right, if ukugobela o right, you will never get sick. Immediately once waqala ukuphehlelelwa, immediately waqala intwaso yakho, you see progress and change in your life. Uyezwa ngisho ukhuleka ukuthi itone yakho it has changed. Uyezwa ngisho wenza izinto eziningi ukuthi cha, things have changed. You feel change in your body, you feel change in your life and yonke into, not you and also in your family as well. Then that's a sign to say le process oyihambayo okanye nalo muntu ohanjiswa naye uyena muntu ke ochuzeleyo yena abantu abadala. So don't get stuck in places just because uyasaba ukuphuma, you are scared of that gobela to even approach that person ukuthi but mkhulu okanye gogo I'm not seeing change, I'm getting sick, instead ngishawa ngezichitho and every time when I'm given izimpande to cleanse myself it's like things are just getting worse. then that's an indication for you. Leave that place and go home. Bantwana bedlozini baningi who are stuck emaphehlweni ekufanele ngabe in the first place anikho kuona. That is why you don't see change in your life. That is why you don't see growth in your life, because it goes to an extent la ukuthi uhlele ephehlweni izinto ayihambi kahle. Ugobele ugcine esehambe esefuna nezinye izinto athi hayi mhlambe khona okungalungile nasekhaya. You end up going in izinhambe nekhaya emsamo wasekhaya niyokwenza izinto khona. Kanti seniya usuyaxova kakhulu. Don't be stuck in a place where you're not supposed. When you are there and you feel ukuthi no, koninde wrong la, then there is something wrong. Go home, leave that place. Yo, I feel sad because baningi abantu abahlale bebhekene nale problem. Baningi abantu engihlale ngikhuluma nabo abaface le problem le. Usephehlweni awuboni a change in your life, then that place is just not for you. Understand one thing, once wabasephehlweni, a huge red flag, once wabasephehlweni, and each and every one of you, wonke amathwasa kulelo khaya, nine uniform, yokwenza izinto, bengithi uniform, nenziswa izinto ngendlela eyodwa, nonke nizinkamba ngendlela eyodwa, nonke nifaka ubuhlalo bonke obufanayo, nonke nenziswa into eyodwa, nithi nina benihleli nje nihleli phansi ngathi nigqoke uniform yasesikoleni, nonke niyafana. That's a red flag for you. Iphehla kufanele libe njalo. Ulapho wena ngokuzolapha eyakho imimoya esike izofuna ubuhlalo bayo obuthize. Right? Ngiyabona ubuhlalo okusuke kukhulunywa ngokuthi ubuhlalo bakhona kulelo ziko lelo kulona. Right? Ngiyakubona lokho okusuke nibufaka bonke ngoba phela fanele ulinke nedlozi lakhona ngoba ekugcineni uzohlanganisa imimoya kuze lakhe idlozi lizothola usizo nawe uthola usizo. I'm talking about where in instance la nonke nizofaka ubuhlalo bonke elifanayo, nonke nifana yonke into efanayo, akekho nje yena osehlukile. Mhlambe vele awuzele ngisho ukuthi nobungoma yethu usufaka izinto zobungoma, kanti wena nje bekufanele ngabe uzophakanyiselwa isithunywa, uzibona uthi udla lezi inkamba mhlambe lezi ezinye zendiki nezinye nani, uzibona ugula ukhishwa isisu, uzibona ukhathala, you feel drained. It's because that is just not for you. That's just not for you. So focus, stay focused. Don't be scared. If you feel ukuthi khona into wrong, remember usephehlweni you've left your family. Remember usephehlweni there's money spent for you being there. Remember usephehlweni umzimba wakho, impilo yakho, intwaso it's your life. So if ever kukhona into wrong that you experiencing or kukhona into wrong abantu abadala abakutshengisa yona, and when are you scared to approach ugobela wakho, or you scared to just walk out from that place, uzilimaza wena at the end of the day. So ezinye izinto ukusaba angeke kuze kukusize. Ezinye izinto you take action and you leave that place. Noma ngabe ke ugobela bakuvezelile abantu abadala, sengiphumile ke kuloko kunye. Naba ke abantu abadala sebekuvezelile ukuthi nayi indawo sekufanele uhambe uyothwasa kuyona, bazokuyisa khona, uhambe uye khona. Ubona izinto zakho ziqaqekela zikhanya zibe zinhle, bakuthwasise ngendlela yakho. Uma belifika idlozi lakho lifika lithi lo mntwana lo ngifuna faka ubuhlalo obubuhlaza, ngifuna faka ubuhlalo obublack and red, sifuna faka ubuhlalo obunjani, fika ugobela wakho ngoba uyalalela idlozi lakho, akufaka ubuhlalo bayo idlozi lakho, afike enze ngendlela yakho. Belithi idlozi cha lo akazi ugcoba ibofu, uzokwenza ukuthi nokuthi afika ugobela wakho angakugcoba ibofu, angayenzi zonke lezo zinto, enze ngendlela abantu abadala. Nize niyofika to his point ukuthi usuyaphuma uthula, wenza umsebenzi wakho wokuphothula, your initiation day, uphumile wena manje lapho usu right in everything. Listen, akusafaneleke wena usuzimele usekhiphile ugobela ngendlela yedlozi abathe phuma ngayo kuyena, and then wena usuvulelwe isigodlo sakho usafuna ukuphila ngama morals nangendlela yokwenza yalowo gobela. No, remember one thing, lesi sakho isigodlo sinabaphathi baso. Remember that. Esakho isigodlo sinabaphathi baso. Labe kuyibona ukade uzobavulela leso sigodlo. Abanini baleso sigodlo. So awukwazi ke ukuthatha indlela ugobela wakho enza ngayo yena, ngoba yena wenza ngemfundiso yemimoya yakhe naye. Yena uhambisiwe kuyena ngoba bebazi ukuthi this is a pure person, and two, mostly abantu abadala bebekisa kulo gobela basuke bethande impande yakhe lowo gobela, ngoba bayayazi ukuthi i-unique ngayiphi indlela, bayayazi ukuthi inamandla kangakanani, ihambisana nabo.
So as nizinto, I guidance nama teachings basuke befuna vele uwathole ngoba bayamaza ukuthi umuntu onjani. Kodwa usukhishiwe wena usuwumungoma or usuyilendlela yonke lendlela osukukade uinitiatela yona. You out there sebenza ngendlela yemimoya yakho, sebenza ngendlela yedlozi lakho. Don't adopt istayela sakwagobela wakho. If kukhona ukuthize abasuke abantu abadala besuke befuna ukuadopt from that person, they will tell you ukuthi nakho ke ongafanele ukwenze ngoba sayithanda indlela enza ngayo naye kanje kanje kanje. But musa yonke into wena usakwazi ukuzenzela ama decisions, yonke into usuhlale uthembele kugobela usukwenza ngendlela owawukade utshengiswe ngayo. Lalela bakhe abantu ukuthi wena esabo isigodlo wena uzosebenza kanjani. If esabo isigodlo wena uma buzo consultela umuntu mhlambe uzo someone is coming for a consultation, if bethi cha awuzukhanyisa isibani shisa impepho kuphela, you do that. Ungazi confuse ukuthi phatha isoka gobela ukuthi bekhanyiswa izibani kukhanyiswa impepho. Abanye bangathi uzokhanyisa impepho uzokhanyisa ikhandlela elimhlophe. Maybe you know kwagobela ukuthi benikhanyisa white, yellow, blue, you know, but lalela bakho ukuthi bathini because bona it le ndlela abazokutshela ngayo ukuthi when someone is coming for a consultation uzomfunda lowo muntu spiritually, uzongena deeper into spirituality sabo. Bayazi bona ukuthi this is what you need to do, this is what you need to use as godless sakho. So don't adopt too much of a style asagobela wakho ukuthi yena ubenza kanjani. Lalele yakhe imimoya ukuthi wena uzosebenza kanjani. Okay, so ezinye izinto lezo ezinilimazayo kakhulu, you must always see ama red flags ngentethizi. Don't get stuck endaweni ubona kahle ukuthi that place is just not for you. What is it maybe I might be forgetting in terms of lokho, because hi ni bhekene nenkinga yabona lento of being stuck ephehlweni engabe fanele ngabe uyaphuma kulona, but you scared, especially to those abavele bathi ngiyasaba gogo, ngiyasaba sebengitshengise ngazo zonke abantu abadala indlela, but ngiyamosaba ugobela wami. Uzilimaza wena, uzilimaza wena in the first place, ngoba first place because it's either fake nanobuhlalo obukusindayo obukulimazayo obungahambisani neyakho imimoya. It's either nezimpande onikezwa zona azihambisani nabo, instead it's just making you sick. Ugcine usubuzwa abantu abadala sebethule kanti hayi ngoba bethuli, bafuna uphume ngoba sebekutshengise ngazo zonke iy'ndlela, they've shown you the signs ukuthi hamba lana, this place is just not for you. Please bantwana bedlozi, listen to that. Oh, okay, yeah, so please listen to your instinct yakho, especially abantwana abalaba basuke besephehlweni, ngoba all the time idlozi lakho liyakhuluma. So lilalele ukuthi lithini. Ungasi adopt istyler sakhe. What if uadopta istyler sakhe kunezinto ezithile ugobela wakho angazenzi, kanti wena unemoya ephakeme yona esebenza ngeyindlela eziningi. Usu adopta leso styler usucindezela idlozi lakho. What if yena unedlozi elicathuzayo, idlozi elislow, izinto eziningi azivezi ngeyindlela eziningi. Uthi uyamtshela mhlambe ngezinto ezithise, ngiphupha amabhaya athize, ngiphupha amajazi athize, athi cha awukakafiki wena kuleyo level. Talk about abantu kade besho nje athi gogo mina ngiyamtshela ukuthi ngiphupha ijazi elimnyama elinesiphika esikanje okanye alinaso isiphika, athi cha awukakafiki wena kuleyo level. Gogo ngiphupha ingubo emnyama ngiyigqokile benginikeza abantu abadala, athi cha awukakafiki wena kuleyo level. Athi ngiphupha benginikeza ingubo bathi nansi ingubo ezokulapha, gqoka le ngubo le uyithola. Uthi uyamtshela athi cha awufikile wena to that level, you can't be wearing that. But iyona sembatha bakunikeza sona at that time ukuthi isona esizokulapha, isona esizokulekelela, isona esizokusiza. So once ugobela wakho wafuna reject izimbatho ezithizo sokuvezela abantu abadala just because ethi yena mhlamba kanalo lawo majazi okanye kanawo lelo bhayi okanye, you need to understand. I've heard somewhere also kukhona othi idlozi alisoze lakunikeza amajazi okanye amabhayi ugobela wakho anganawo. That is a pure lie. Asinayo imimoya efanayo Remember that. So elakho idlozi beliknikezile izinto. Akusho ukuthi fanele liknikeze zonke izinto ugobela wakho anazo. If ugobela wakho enamajazi o 1 or 2 or 3, wena elakho idlozi likuvezele amajazi awu 10. So it means when lawa manje ngeke uzowathole, lawa majazi akho aphakamisa imimoya ethize, there is a purpose for each and every one of isembatho sokusinikezwa idlozi.
So having said that, you must know ukuthi once ugobela wakho wakuphikisa kwezembatho oyifunayo, or once washtshengisa a face of anger or being annoyed or irritated uthi uyambikela ukuthi kunezembatho engiyitshengiswa abantu abadala just because yena kanazo, and then athi no awakafiki kuleyo level, then just know that is not the person for you. Angeke kuze kuthi wonke amajazi onawo fanele nogobela wakho abe nawo. And okunye ngiyaye ngikubone lokho kuthi ubona umuntu eseyophothulisa the day of the initiation, right? And then you seeing umuntu egqoke njengogobela wakhe. I'm talking about ijazi la gobela wakhe and everything ukufana ntse nogobela wakhe and everything. Yonke into ifana negobela wakhe. Okay, wena le mimoya yakho okade uzoyi-initiator, akusekho khona leni yona la ihluka khona ukuthi wena lucky jazz lizohluka ngento ethize, wena lucky jazz lizohluka ngento ethize. Just be careful ezinye izinto. Nabogobela abanye bathanda uku-adopta istayela sala akade ethwasiswe khona. Nayo uyothi uyobona ugogo lo ekuthi ugogo lo asuka amthwasisa yena ugogo kuwena, ngoba ugobela wakho uzoba umama okanye uzoba umkhulu. Ubone nogogo ugqoke the same jazz eligqoke ugogo ugobela wakho, uphinde kugqokiswe nawe the same jazz in your initiation day. Just know ukuthi I don't feel this. Angeke imimoya yakho, sonke sinimimoya engafani. Okwakho kungafana yesi nokomunye, kodwa kube khona la okuzoyihlukela khona kodwa. Please, musani ukuhlala eindaweni, nistake eindaweni nizibonayo khona ukuthi ayiki progress. Because some of you, njengoba nibona abantu abadala bekhuluma bethi hamba la, ufunani la, it's because abanye beni akufanele angani ngabe bayathwasa in the first place. Please, bantwana bedlozi, just be careful. And then nalento yokuthi nihlale niletha abantu emsamo. I'm just talking about izinto currently abantu abaningi are facing. If ulethe umelaphi othize emsamo, nafike kuthiwa nizolungisa into ethize, along the time, in a short period of time, you still seeing the same problems that you called that person for ekhaya. Kuphinde nithi niyaletha omunye manje uzolungisa lokhu, niphinde niletha omunye manje uzolungisa lokhu. Just be careful of that. Because meaning akekho ngisho yedwa usayitholile i-core ye problem lensuke nibhekene nayo ekhaya. Is that it? Or maybe there is no problem whatsoever ekhaya. It's just that bekufanele nihlambulule umsamo. Maybe ukhona othe hayi kudingeka ukuthi nihlambulule umsamo, but impande ayisebenzisile yokuhlambulula umsamo was not the one, or indlela yakhe yokwenza ayihambisananga nedlozi lakho. So just be careful. And before I close off, bantwana bedlozi, uma bekuzoba khona umuntu wasekhaya okanye umelaphi noma ngabe ubani omunye athi sithenga imbuzi emnyama to uyogeza idlozi, just be careful of that. Just be careful of that. Ukuthi kuthiwa thenga imbuzi emnyama, mase kuthiwa phuza igazi layo, ugeze ngegazi layo, ugeze ngomswani wayo, uzutetiswe nayo. That's witchcraft. So be careful. That pains me to hear such stories from abantu esuke sesisebenzisana ngiba sisebenzisana nabo when I have to fix yonke leyo nto esiyenzekile. Ngiyanicela, idlozi lihlambululwa ngento emhlophe. Angeke ngithi mina thenga imbuzi emnyama yokuthi uyohlambulula idlozi mase ngithetha leyo mbuzi ngikutetise ngayo. Cha. Anike nibe careful kwezinye izinto kuthi nenza kanjani, please. Okunye futhi I want just to add, don't expect a change eyintweni eyiningi if nawe ungakalungisi izinto zakho zabantu abadala. Don't expect ukuthi sekuzoba khona that huge change in your life nawe izinto zabantu abadala ungakayilungisi. You went for a consultation, wahamba mhlambe wayokwenza cleansing, wenza ngezinye izindlela mhlambe zokuphakamisa imimoya yakho. Kodwa kusanamanye amadates mhlambe during your consultation ayenzeka ukuthi let's say abantu abadala bakhala ngokuthi ulakhile ikhaya kodwa unawo umsamo. Awunawo umsamo, awubafakile abantu abadala zonke lezo zinto kanjalo. Okanye there are many reasons oyisuke kusakhona izinto osuke usakweleta kuzona. Bakuvulela abantu abadala laba afuke befuna ukuvulela khona, but however still ungenzi izinto ngendlela right. So musa kuba usukhala usuthi ay mina ngisazi ukuthi abantu abadala sekufanele ngenze njani, because I've done 1, 2, 3, 4 kodwa manje still I'm not seeing a huge change. Yes, I see a slight different, but however I'm not seeing ukuthi izinto fanele ngabe sezi 100%. Khumbula phela ukuthi akwakayiqedi izinto owathembisa, because siyathanda ukuthembisa mase kufanele sidelive kuba iproblem. And mase abantu abadala sebesiphile amandla ukuthi silungise lezo zinto zethu. If unomuzi wena uthengile umuzi ubukade uphahla ekameleni lakho all the time, and then it wazama ukulungisa izinto zabantu abadala, you fixed okunye, but abasha abantu abadala ukuthi ekugcineni akabe nomsamo oproper. Bakupha abantu abadala imali but still ungabakheli indlu yabo abantu abadala, uqhubeke wena uyaphahla ekameleni. Ikamelo lele mhlambe kufike kuphinde futhi uzolala khona no partner wakho, okanye girlfriend, okanye boyfriend, okanye fiance, okanye wife, or noma kabe kanjani, but still ulokhu phahlela kulelo kamelo lelo. Awukazucabanga ukuthi no ngagcina ngithembisa abantu abadala ukuthi ngizobakhela indlu yabo. So unga expect ukuthi ke abantu abadala ke sebekhohliwe leyo debt masu uthwena. But I don't see into, okay, have they not done anything? Yes, they have done, gogo. But mina ngifuna ibusiness, ngifuna imali, ngifuna ukuthi okay, uzobe usubaphahlela kuphi? Uqhubeka uphahla futhi ekameleni? Uqhubeka futhi wenza ngalendlela le ababeyikhalela in the first place? Kodwa leyo lezo zinto leza uyishintshile. Ibalulekile indle abantu abadala, bantwana bedlozi, especially if you have a property ongakwazi ukuthi uyakhe indle abantu abadala. It's very very important ukuthi idlozi lakho nawo ubufuna libe active, idlozi lakho ubufuna likuphakamele, likuphakele. Xhumanani nizwane nalo, baphe nabo indle yabo abazokwazi ukuthi bahlale kuyona. Akuzothi nakhona nabanye abazofuna ukuzovakasha bakwazi ukufika bangene kuleyo ndlu leyo. But busaqhubeka usalokhu uphahla emsamo, sebekuphila amini ekameleni, sebekuphile kodwa amandla yokuthi bakhele indlu ukwathathe wena amandla. Mhlawumbe uvele usuke uyirenovatele indlu yakho, noma uhambe uyoyithengela imoto, uzenzele ezinye izinto, ungabe usabuyela lapho uphinde ukhohle ukuthi konje ngangithembise ukuthi ngizobakhela abantu abadala. Enza into osuke kade uyithembisile edlozini uma masekukhona la abakuvulela khona. Ngiyaphinda abantwana bedlozi, enzani izethembiso, nigcine izethembiso enabathembisa bona zona abantu abadala. The day ubaphakamisa ubacela ukuthi abakuvulele indlela, bakuvulela ke indlela, but wena still awenzi ngendlela ababekade besho ngayo. Kwesinye isikhathi bakutshengisa ukuthi lo partner osempilweni yakho asimdingi, uyena ukucindezelayo. Ungaphumi wena kupartner, uqhubeke uhlale nalewo partner. No one thing angeke uzuyibone vele i-change in your life, because khona lokho okukodwa ongafuni ukukwenza. You know very well ukuthi ufanele ukwenza lokhu, ukuthi hayi ngizokwenza ukuthi manje ngisuke ngabothi ufanele ngenze lokhu. Ayi even limaza ke leyo nto leyo. So pay close attention to that. Zigcina izethembiso oyithembisa abantu abadala.